Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Shireen. I would appreciate if you please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. This is a question and answer video in which I'll be answering all your questions, which are frequently asked questions. So the first is, which is very basic, how to mix resin accurately. So whatever resin you're using, you need to go through the guidelines and see whether it's a 1:1 ratio, 2:1 or 3:1 ratio resin. So accordingly you have to measure it very precisely. Do not mess up with the measurement because it will mess up with your art. Take part A and part B, put it in one cup and then mix it very slowly, scraping the sides and the bottom. Just make sure you mix it at least for 5 minutes and then you will see the resin will be clear and there will be very few bubbles left when you will be done with mixing. So this shows that you have mixed the resin perfectly and then you're ready to pour. Second question is, why is my resin sticky? So this has really happened with me recently, although I'm working with resin from 1.5 years, and I couldn't believe that I can do this mistake, but this has happened. I use 3:1 ratio resin. So what happened, I took 3 cups of part A and I forgot to add part B. Can you believe that? I don't know where my mind was. Without adding part B, I mixed the colors, poured it on my coasters. Everything was set. I was liking it. It was really nice looking coasters. Then when I went to sleep, I realized that I did not add part B. And then I went to my craft room and saw that it was sticky. Really, I forgot it. And it was such a blunder which I had made. So why is your resin sticky? You just got the answer now. What I did, it was a blunder that you forgot to mix part B. Second is that if you not taken the measurement correctly and mixed part A and part B. Third reason would be if you have not mixed the resin properly. So I just told that you need to give at least 5 minutes of mix. How to fix this? Give another coat with the perfectly mixed and with accurate measurement of resin and give it a second coat. It'll be absolutely fine. A third question, which is also very basic, what color should I use with resin? So I have experimented with all the colors, all types of colors, be it acrylic, oil paints or makeup like eyeshadows or blush. I have even used highlighters, nail paints. So it was absolutely fine. Even I have used chalk paints. It gives you a very matte kind of finish. But remember, the effects will be different with different sort of colors. With oil paints, it is different. I have faced some issues with oil paints. So I have stopped using oil paints. I use acrylic chalk paints. And also these days I'm getting resin pigments from Dubai or from some other countries, because in Oman I'm not getting resin pigments. So that's why I was experimenting with so many colors. So if you're a beginner and you're not finding resin pigments, or it's not available, or your pocket is not allowing you to buy resin pigments because these are really expensive colors, then you can go with any sort of colors you have at that moment. Art is all about experimenting. The more you experiment, the more results you will get and more ideas you will get, and you will become perfect in that one day. Just trust me on that, because nobody has taught me this resin art, but it has become my profession now. So I'm so happy that people are coming to me and asking me, and I'm doing this video for you all. So coming back to our video, so the next question, which is very much asked by me, is how to make a barrier. So what I do is I like to experiment a lot. If you have seen my videos, my artwork, everything, I have made coasters, some hanging things. Just take a normal garbage bag, because resin will not stick to it, and then make any sort of shape you like with hot glue guns. But make sure once the first layer is dry, because it dries very quickly, then only make the second layer, third and fourth, whatever you feel like. So I make my barriers like this, but with silicone also you can make it if you can find silicone in your place. For silicone, you have to wait for almost 24 hours to dry it up, and then you need to start working with your resin. So I have kept this video really short, just 5 questions, and the last question is, what temperature does the resin cure? The temperature should be 70 to 75 degree Fahrenheit. It should not be very cool or it should not be very hot. So make sure the temperature is fine wherever you are working or in whatever country you are in. So that's all for the video. I hope you've liked it. I hope it is helpful. I'll be doing more series on Q&As because I have obviously not covered all the questions because I don't want to lengthy up the video. I want the video should be short and sweet so that anyone can watch it anytime. So if you have any other queries, just let me know. Comment me. Also, you can DM me, you can email me. Everything will be mentioned in my description box. You can chat with me also. There'll be no problem. I can help you out personally with your artwork, whatever issue you're facing. Unless you'll experiment, you won't find the difficulties, you won't find the problems and the solutions to it. So just go for it. Do whatever you want. Do whatever you feel like. Do whatever you love. And till then, take care of yourself. Be safe. Please be safe. Don't go out unless it's important. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.